Hi there, this is Peter from Xoyo. I want to show you a tutorial how to place a road on a terrain in Blender. I wanted to demonstrate two different options, and please remember, if you like this video, grant me a like or even subscribe to our channel. So let's go. Okay, so this is our base file that we want to work with. Let me quickly explain the components. The first one is our terrain, which is just exemplary for any terrain you might want to use. It's a simple subdivided plane. And on top of that, I got a displacement modifier, which is displaced by a texture, in this case, a cloud map. But as I said, any kind of terrain might work. And further on, I smoothed the plane a little to get rid of these hard edges here. Further on, I got a simple curve here, which has been displaced a couple of times, which should represent the street shape that we want to go with. And last but not least, here I got the more detailed street segments. That's for the option 2 that I talked about before. So let's start with the more simple version beforehand. This is a plane which has been subdivided in the Y axis a couple of times. So first we gonna apply an array modifier to lengthen our road module to the right length. And I applied this array modifier, change this setting to fit curve, and select my curve over here. So that's already step one. The next modifier we're gonna use is the weld modifier, which helps us to weld all the sections between the different modules. So in the end, now this should be one consistent, smoothened plane, but obviously we can't see that right now. So finally, we are applying the curve modifier, and I'm picking my curve object to follow along with. Now, that curve object obviously needs to be right on top of my street, and now we have a curve that's smoothly following our line. On top of my street, I'm applying a subdivision modifier again, which helps us to align our road a little more smoothly onto our terrain. Now finally, I'm moving my whole construct over the terrain and use the shrink wrap modifier over here. Change the wrapping mode to projection, only using the Z axis. Now finally, I'm picking my target, which would be my terrain, and then I also apply positive and negative direction. This will help moving it a little in the Y axis to completely conform my road onto a terrain. Now what we're gonna do to make our own actually our road more visible, what we can do is to solidify our road. Probably we have to do it a little in both directions, here and there, and then to make it look a little smoother, you might want to apply a subdivision modifier, potentially smoothen your road flat. And now looking at the whole thing like this, you can see that the road is nicely applied on top of the terrain. My one benefit we're having here is that I can now actually move the terrain. I can change the displacement, and the road will react completely flexible. The same goes obviously also for the direction my road is taking. So if you want to play with this, and it's actually quite fascinating how interactive and smooth this really works. So this would be option 1. So what's option two? Well, let's assume you need something a little more realistic and still want to retain the same kind of flexibility. You could work with a more detailed road model. I prepared this model here. Let me show the wireframe. And it's one object, one mesh that I'm working with here right now. So how could we apply this to our road? Well, firsthand, I'm picking my road that I just generated. And for the moment, let's just turn off most modifiers that we're working with and move the whole object to the side. I'm picking my more detailed road model. Let's make sure it's on top of the other one, something like this. And again, I'm using an array modifier on my new road model. Same procedure, fit to curve, picking the curve that I want to use. Then again, using a weld modifier with a proper distance to weld the arrayed object to one smooth final object. And now what we want to do is to use the surface deform modifier over here. So what the surface deform modifier does, it enables us to make use of a base object. In this case, our simple road, to a more complex object. In this case, our complex road. And then at one point, you have to commit this by binding it to the new object. So I hit the bind button. And that actually should be already what we need to do for our road. Now we reapply the curve modifier. As you already can see, our new road has been conformed to the new curve. We don't need this subdivision modifier over here. Let's move the bunch of our three roads over the terrain again. Pick our simple road and now shrink it back onto the road that you can see over here. I don't need to solidify the base object and actually don't need any further subdivisions. You might want to play with your smoothing groups a little, but in the end, that's exactly what we want to do. And again, this whole setup proves to be quite flexible. If you strengthen the length too much, then the surface deform will bug out because the number of vertices will change. But if you retain the same length of your road, this should work just fine. Okay, so I hope this was pretty useful for you and see you in the next tutorial. Bye bye.